Welcome to the New South Wales Restrictive Practices Authorisation System video tutorials. Each video focuses on a different part of the RPA system. This video demonstrates the features of the menu bar. The RPA system always opens on the home screen after you have logged on. You can access this at any time by clicking on Home in the menu bar. The menu bar is found on top of the screen just underneath the logo. The menu bar contains links to all pages in the RPA system. The access to various menu items is dependent upon your user access type. We will now go through these items and provide you with an overview. Moving from left to right, starting with the home screen, this screen provides a summary of submission by category compared to the state, a list of outstanding and pending actions to be completed by the user, and a news announcement board. The next menu item is the dashboard. The dashboard provides metrics and analytical views of restrictive practices submissions for your organisation. The next menu item is the participant page. You would need to access this page to add, edit, or to view all participants created by your organisation. There is a separate video for creating a participant. The fourth menu item is the RPA submission page. All RPA submissions are listed on this page. Once a submission form has been created, you can search for it by clicking on RPA submission. There are a number of videos that have been created detailing how to complete an RPA submission. The next item, outcome, provides a list of all RPA outcome summaries for submissions that have been released to an RPA panel. For more information, please refer to the outcome videos available. The next menu item is the review page. If the panel has requested that the authorisation is reviewed, it will have been created automatically in the system. A review can be created at any time, and once created, it can be found in the review page. Please see the review videos for further information. The service provider menu item provides details of your organisation. You can update contact details at any time if required. The practitioner menu item lists all practitioners who have been registered in the New South Wales RPA system. If a practitioner is not yet registered, you can add them. How to do this is explained in the video Adding a Practitioner. The panel meeting menu item provides an option for you to view a list of upcoming panel meetings. This is particularly useful for the person organising the panel and those attending a panel. If you are the organisation administrator for your organisation, you will see the user management menu item. All other roles do not have this menu item. This allows the organisation administrator to add users and create branches. Please refer to the Organisation Administrator video for further information. The Reports menu item provides a list of predetermined reports that you can access. Each report opens in an Excel spreadsheet that you can filter as applicable. The Help menu item provides a list of useful resources such as the RPA System User Guide and Quick Reference Guides, which are written documents similar to these videos. A feature included throughout the RPA system is the Help button. Clicking on the question mark symbol opens up a short description of what is required to be entered in the applicable field. We hope that you find these videos useful. Thank you.